Clean water advocates are saying stop to the Army Corps of Engineers. That is because they are about to release more water from Lake Okeechobee into the Caloosahatchee River.
Heavy discharges can cause environmental damage, including blue-green algae blooms, along with health problems for people and marine life. We sent NBC2's Zach Barrett to find out how much water we can expect.
When Brett Andrews visits Florida, he's throwing a line in the Caloosahatchee.
I wouldn't come to Florida without my fishing gear.
But the makeup of the river will be changing this week, as fresh water is expected to flow in from a swelling Lake Okeechobee.
The lake crossed 16 feet over the weekend, and that's at the point where they have to manage it.
The problem is, experts say there's too much water in the Caloosahatchee already.
It's 2 feet higher than it was last year, so it's pretty high.
The Army Corps of Engineers saying Friday they could release as much as 4,000 cubic feet per second into the river.
To put that in perspective, 4,000 cubic feet per second equals out to about 30,000 gallons of Lake O water that could be flowing into the Caloosahatchee every second.
That would put us 2 to 3 times above that harmful range.
Policy director with the Sanibel Captiva Conservation Foundation, James Evans, says if all that water heads here, it could form toxic algae and take a toll on our water quality.
Expect a dark water plume that will go out well into the Gulf of Mexico. It will darken the water around our islands.
The Caloosahatchee will also see more Lake O water than the St. Lucie estuary on the East Coast, partly due to the difference in sizes to the bodies of water and how much water is pooling up in the lake.
It takes a little longer to see those impacts from the discharges, whereas the St. Lucie sees those impacts almost immediately.
Experts say a toxic algae bloom doesn't look likely right now, but even if it does, Brett says he'll be out there.
It wouldn't keep me from going unless I saw, you know, reports or fish with three eyes or, you know, extra fins coming out.
The Army Corps has yet to decide how much fresh water will be released, releases that could start as early as tomorrow. Reporting in Lee County, Zach Barrett, NBC2.